Labially erupted maxillary canine is mostly due to. So here they have asked us what is the etiology for a maxillary canine to erupt labially. Okay, whether it is because the lateral incisor has erupted before the canine has erupted before the premolars have erupted before the canine, or the canine has erupted before the lateral incisor. Now, whenever there is displacement or impaction of the maxillary canine, there are two possibilities. Either the canine is going to be displaced labially, or the canine is going to be displaced palatally. Now, the etiology of both of these situations is very different from each other. Okay, in a palatally displaced canine, the etiology is the genetic predisposition. So there is a lack of guidance because either there is a peg-shaped lateral that is present in the arch, or there is a missing lateral. Okay, now the roots of the lateral incisor basically help to guide the canine into the arch. So whenever there is a lateral incisor that is missing or has an abnormal shape, okay, this guidance is lost, because of which the canine gets impacted palatally, okay, or displaced palatally. But for a labially erupting canine, this is not the etiology, or the etiology for the labially erupting canine is very different. That is crowding. Okay, in 83% of the cases where there is a labially positioned canine, the reason is crowding. Okay, so here what we see in these options, okay, in all of these what we see is that there is some, they are mentioning about the eruption sequence. Okay. So, whenever there is a disruption in the normal eruption pattern, the normal eruption, okay, or any abnormality in the eruption sequence, then this could lead to crowding, which is going to displace the canine labially. Okay, so what is the normal eruption sequence that is seen? So, in the maxilla, okay, the incisors erupt first, then the premolar erupts, and then the maxillary canine erupts. Okay, in the mandible, the incisors erupt, then the canine erupts, and then the premolars erupt. Okay, so canine erupting before the premolars is normal in the mandibular arch, but that is not normal in the maxillary arch. Okay, so here if you see in the options, lateral incisor erupting before the canine, this is normal. Okay, this is not going to cause a labial movement of the canine. Now, canine erupting before the premolars, this is normal for mandibular but not for maxillary. Okay, premolar erupting before the canine, this is normal in the case of maxilla. Okay, so this will not cause a labial displacement of the canine, because this is what is normally seen. Now, canine eruption before the lateral incisor, this might lead to transposition of the tooth. Okay, this might be because either the lateral incisor is missing, okay, or the canine has erupted before the lateral incisor. So now the lateral incisor may erupt in the place of the canine, or it may be impacted. Okay, so either there will be transposition or there will be impaction of the lateral incisor, or it is that the lateral incisor is missing. Okay, however, if the canine erupts before the premolar, okay, which is not the normal sequence for a maxillary arch, the canine will occupy the space that was going to be taken up by the premolars. So now when the premolars start erupting, they are going to push the canine ahead because they do not have any place. So there's going to be crowding in the arch, and because of this push, the canines will be labially displaced. Okay, so the answer for this question is, canine eruption before the premolars might lead to a labially erupted maxillary canine.